Ma'am, page number 32.
Page number 32. And which para? The first one?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Put the date.
Yes, ma'am.
Written. Should I continue, children? Now, what was Hannah doing in American's room? What was he doing? Hello? Internet connection is unstable. Hello, am I audible, beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So what was Hannah doing there in the American's room? What did Yumi refuse to do? What did Yumi refuse to do?
Ma'am, to wash the man.
Yes. To wash the white
man. To wash the white man.
So Hannah, she started herself cleaning the white man, and while cleaning, she was thinking about the fine texture the man had, okay? That prisoner had, right? And she was thinking if the prisoner is having such a fine texture, then he might have been very blonde when he was a small child, right? So the next para. While she was thinking these thoughts, yes, though not really liking the man better now that he was no longer a child, she kept on washing him until his upper body was quite clean. Now, Hannah, she was lost in all these thoughts, though she did not like to wash this man better. And she thinks that he is no longer a child, but anyhow, she has to wash him. So she kept washing him until his upper body, it was clean. But she dare not turn him over. But now see, she did not have this dareness, this boldness to touch him, to hold him and turn him over onto his face. Where was Sadao? Now she looks for Dr. Sadao, and her anger was ebbing. Ebbing means it was rising. And she was anxious again, and she rose, wiping her hands on the wrong towel. So now her anger, you know, it started rising up. Why? Because Dr. Sadao was not there to help her to turn this man. And she became so anxious that she got up and she wiped her hands on the wrong towel. Maybe the towel that was used by her to wipe this or to wash this American. Then lest the man be chilled, she put the quilt over him. And she thought that the man, he would be chilled. He would feel cold, so she covers him with a quilt. Quilt, I told you, what is a quilt? What is a quilt?
Ma'am, a blanket. Ma'am, blanket.
Yes, blanket, okay, a woolen.
Ma'am, blanket.
Blanket, okay, having lot of cotton stuffed in it. Rajai, jisko hum kehte hai na. So she covered him with the soft quilt. Sadao, she called softly. He had been about to come in when she called. His hand had been on the door and now he opened it. She saw that he had brought his surgeon's emergency bag and that he wore his surgeon's coat. Okay. So very softly, she called Sadao, and as she called, Sadao was about to enter, and when he enters, Hannah sees that he had brought his surgeon's emergency bag and he was wearing his surgeon's coat. You have seen doctors when they operate, they wear a different long coat, you know, isn't it? Green colored. We see green colored coat they just put on and then they operate the patients, okay? So even he was wearing that surgeon's coat.
Yes, ma'am.
You have decided to operate, she cried. Now she was very much shocked that Dr. Sadao had decided to operate. Yes, he said shortly. He turned his back to her and unfolded a sterilized towel. Sterilized, you got it? What is sterilized? Yes, only Anushka is there to answer. Why can't others answer? Yes, why can't you answer? What is sterilized?
Body part of a human doesn't work.
Pardon? Body part did
not work. Hygienic.
That is sterilized. What is it? Before operation, the charles and the instruments, they are boiled, you know. They are sterilized in hot water. That is sterilized. Samajh mein aaya? Before using for the operation. Before using. Okay, for the surgery, jitni bhi charles hoti hain, jo instruments doctors use karte hain na, unhe boil kara jata hai, uske baad use mein laya jata hai, hote hain sterilized. Got it, beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The sterilized chal upon the floor of the Tokunuma alcove. Now, Tokunuma alcove, the meaning has been given there. You take a simple meaning, ek shelf bana hua tha uspe. He just unfolded the sterilized chal and put his instruments upon it. Okay, he laid the chal and upon it he placed all his instruments that were to be used for the surgery. Fetch chals. Okay, and he asked Kahana to bring the chals. She went obediently, but how anxious now to the linen shelves and took out the towels. There ought also to be old pieces of matting so that the blood would not ruin the fine floor covering. She went out to the back veranda where the gardener kept strips of matting with which to protect delicate shrubs on cold nights and took an armful of them. Okay, so very obediently she obeyed her husband, went inside, but now she was quite anxious. Why? Because she had to take out all the linen towels and the napkins, everything, and then she thinks that there might be the old pieces of matting. Matting, you got it? Mat, you know, it was spread, it was laid on the floor, and the floor was covered with the mat. So now here, this was the room of Dr. Sadao's father. It was a beautiful room, a beautiful matting. It covered the floor. Hana did not want the matting to be ruined. Okay, as the prisoner of war was very dirty and had lot of blood on his body, so she didn't want that the matting of the floor should be spoiled. So she thinks that the old pieces of matting that are kept there in the gardener, what did the gardener do when the mat, it became very old and torn? He used to cut pieces of the mat and he used it to cover the shrubs during the cold season. Okay, shrubs are the small plants and all, unko thand mein cover karne ke liye he used those strips of matting. He used to cover it. To Hana ko ekdam yaad aata hai ki old pieces of matting must be lying there. I must bring those pieces of matting and must place under the prisoner so that the matting that covered the room, okay, that beautiful matting, it might not get ruined. Okay, jo matting jis lagi hui thi na kamre mein wo kharab nahi ho, to main pieces of matting lekar aungi aur place kar dungi. So similarly, she goes to the garden and she took an armful of strips of matting ki jaldi se main aakar place kar deti hu. But when she came inside the room, she saw this was useless. The blood had already soaked through the packing in the man's wound and had ruined the mat under him. But when she came back, what did she saw? The mat had already been ruined. It had already the stains of dirtiness. It had already the stains of blood that had soaked through the prisoner's wound. Samajh mein aa gaya? Prisoner's ke wound se jo already blood nikal kar aa gaya tha, wo mat par lag gaya tha. And wo matting kharab ho gayi thi. So it was useless now for her, those strips of matting. Oh, the mat, aur usko dukh bhi hua, and she says, oh, the mat, to Sadao se kehta, yes, it is ruined. Okay, now you better help me to turn him. Come on, help me. I'm going to turn him. Okay, I'm going to put him on his face and then he should be cleaned from the back also. So she obeyed him without a word and he began to wash the man's back carefully. Hana did not say a single word, obeyed her husband. The man was turned and Dr. Sadao, he started washing the man. Yumi would not wash him. Now Hanashi complains about Yumi ki Yumi refused to wash him. Did he wash him then? Sadao ne pucha. Bhai Yumi ne mana kar diya to did he wash him? Not stopping for a moment his swift concise movements. Okay? Aur jo apne movements wo kar raha tha swift deep movements patafat the actions wo kar raha tha he did not stop. Bas usse confirm kara ki did he wash then? Yes, she said. He did not seem to hear her. Ab aisa laga ki he did not listen to Hana's answer, but she was used to his absorption when he was at work. But he was very much used ki doctor, she was very much used ki Dr. Sadao, he got absolutely absorbed, you know. Okay, when he was at work, when he operated somebody or when he was treating a patient. She wondered for a moment if it mattered to him what was the body upon which he worked so long as it was for the work he did so excellently. And Hana, she started thinking that does it matter to Dr. Sadao to think that which body, whose body is he trying to cure, okay? Whom is he trying to cure? Whom is he trying to operate? Okay, is it he thinking this that he's trying to operate a prisoner of war who is their enemy? Why? Because he was working very excellently in a very fluent and an excellent manner. He was working. Okay, you will have to give the anesthetic if he needs it. Now, doctor, Hana go directions dete hain ki yadi zarurat padegi to you are going to give this patient the anesthetic. Aye, she repeated blankly, but never have I now. She got little much afraid, scared, feared. Why? Because she said that I have never given any anesthetic to anybody. So she hardly knew to give anesthetic. It's easy enough. Okay, now doctor was very impatient, you know. Why? Because he had to hurry up with the operation. Otherwise, the person would die, the prisoner would die. And he was not thinking right now that this prisoner was his dead enemy. Okay, he was an American. He was just thinking that he was a person and the person, he was a human being and the human being has to be saved on any cost. Okay, so he says it is easy enough to give anesthetic. He was taking out the packing now and the blood began to flow more quickly. Now the packing, how did he pack the wound? Do you remember how did he pack the wound, children? Do you remember when they both went there and
from the sea moss,
okay, he packed it. So now the packing, it was undone, it came out and the blood, you know, it started oozing out, it started flowing out. He peered into the wound with the bright surgeon's light fastened on his forehead. Now he looked inside the wound from the torch, okay? The bright light, you know, you have seen surgeons, you know, they just tie a light with a band on their forehead. Forehead, samajhte ho na, idhar maathe par. Ek light unke paas hoti hai, a kind of a torch that is tied, okay? A belt is attached to them or usse yes, they try to peep into the wounds, okay? When they operate a person. So usne wound mein dekha, the bullet is still there and he saw that the bullet was still there in the wound. He said with cool interest, now I wonder how deep this rock wound is. And then he says, now I understood ki this rock wound is very deep. This wound the prisoner is having, it's quite deep. If it is not too deep, it may be that I can get the bullet. And he thinks that he will operate or in case if the wound is not deep, surely very easily the bullet, it would come out. But the bleeding is not superficial. He has lost much blood. Okay. Lekin bleeding koi superficial nahi hai. Bahut zyada blood he had lost. At this moment, Hana choked. Okay. Hana started feeling giddy. Okay. Felt like retching. Retching means vomiting. He looked up and saw her face the color of sulfur. Bilkul. फी का चेहरा जो होता है वो बिल्कुल उसका पड़ गया पेल फेस. डोंट फेंट ही सेड शार्पली. ही डिड नॉट पुट डाउन हिज एक्सप्लोरिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट. अब वो समझ गया हाना. शी स्टार्टेड फीलिंग गिडी तो उसको कहता है डोंट फेंट. ओके बट डॉक्टर सदाओ डिड नॉट ऑपरेट हिज मूवमेंट्स. ओके ही डिड नॉट पुट डाउन द इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स. और वो कहता है इफ आई स्टॉप नाउ द मैन विल श्योरली डाई एंड नाउ ही हैड स्टार्टेड द ऑपरेशन ही हैड स्टार्टेड द प्रोसीजर ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग दिस पर्सन एंड डॉक्टर वाज राइट ही सेज इफ आई एम गोइंग टू स्टॉप नाउ एंड अटेंड माय वाइफ श्योरली द पेशेंट वुड डाई शी क्लैप्ड हर हैंड्स टू हर माउथ क्लैपिंग यू गॉट इट पुटिंग ओके एंड लीप्ड अप एंड रैन आउट ऑफ द रूम एंड क्विकली शी जस्ट रैन आउट ऑफ द रूम आउटसाइड इन द गार्डन ही हर्ड हर रैचिंग रैचिंग मींस आई टोल्ड यू राइट नाउ इट्स वॉमिटिंग Okay, so outside in the garden, she goes out in the garden and Dr. Sadao, he listens that the wife, Hannah, she was vomiting, but he went on with his work, but he did not have any other option. He had to continue with his work of operating the prisoner. It will be better for her to empty her stomach, he thought. Okay, he had forgotten that, of course, she had never seen an operation. अब डॉक्टर ये भूल गए थे कि हना हैड नेवर सीन एन ऑपरेशन इतना ब्लड वगैरह एंड ओपन वुंड वगैरह तो इस वजह से शी चोक्ड शी फेल्ट गिडी एंड शी वॉमिटेड लेकिन सोचते नाउ इट वुड बी बेटर फॉर हर इफ शी एम्प्टीज हर स्टमक सो मेनी टाइम्स इट हैपेंस यू नो वंस वी वॉमिट वंस वी रेच व्हाट हैपेंस अ स्टमक इट बिकम्स एम्प्टी एंड वी फील बेटर इजंट इट ठीक है काफी बेटर फील करते हैं तो सिमिलरली डॉक्टर सदाव आल्सो थिंक्स द सेम लेकिन ये भूल गए थे हाना हैड नेवर
यस मैम प्रेशर
यस बट हर डिस्ट्रेस एंड हिज इनएबिलिटी टू गो टू हर नाउ ही वाज नॉट एबल टू गो टू हाना ओके डॉक्टर वाज नॉट एबल टू अटेंड हिज वाइफ So this thought at once made him impatient and irritable with this man who lay like dead under his knife. लेकिन जैसे उसने सोचा कि आई एम सो इनएबल यू नो आई एम नॉट एबल अनएबल टू गो एंड अटेंड माय वाइफ ये दिमाग में आते ही वो बड़ा इम्पेशेंट हो जाता है ना ही वाज नॉट टॉलरेंट और इरिटेटेड हो जाता है ठीक है कि बिकॉज ऑफ दिस मैन हु इज लाइंग डेड अंडर माय नाइफ ओके डेड मींस अनकॉन्शियस ही वाज नॉट डेड डेड हियर मींस अनकॉन्शियस ओके So because of this man, I am not able to attend my wife who is vomiting in the garden. This man, he thought there is no reason under heaven why he should live. And then again, a negative thought, it comes into his brain and he says, I don't know the reason why this man should live. Unconsciously, this thought made him ruthless. Okay, he was not conscious. He did not have any kind of this. Thoughts in his mind, unconscious he was about all these things, and just a negative thought came that made him very ruthless, means very rude, very cruel, and he proceeded swiftly. Okay, but he continued in a swift manner, in a fast manner, rapid manner. In his dream, the man moaned. Moaned means cried in pain. Dream means unconscious stage. Why? He was not dead, beta. He was alive, though he was unconscious, but still he was alive. So he was feeling the pain. So he cried in pain, but Sadao paid no heed. Heed, you got it? No attention, except to mutter at him. Except he just whispered, okay, muttered, spoke few words at him. Groan, groan means you just cry in pain. Groan if you like. Grooning is crying in pain, okay? I'm not doing this for my own pleasure. Now see, This was the habit of Dr. Sadao to talk to his patients, okay, while operating. Whether they were conscious or unconscious, he used to talk to his patients. So, अभी भी इसको भी कह रहा है हाँ भाई दर्द से तुम करा रहे हो, you are crying with pain, but groan. What can I do? I am not doing it for my own happiness. In fact, okay, I do not myself know why I am doing it. I myself do not know why I am saving a prisoner of war who is. My enemy, the country, okay, the enemy of my country, he says, I do not know why I'm doing, but it is not for my pleasure. Cry if you want to cry in pain. At that time, the door opened and there was Hannah, okay. The door opens and Hannah, she enters the room once again. Clear, beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
वो आ गया समझ में?
Yes, ma'am.
Sure?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay then. Goodbye. Goodbye and God bless you all.
Thank you, ma'am.